Shalom here from Jerusalem, Israel, a nation that is affected like any other nation in the world by the coronavirus. As I speak to you today, we have 677 people infected by the coronavirus. Thanks God, no casualties so far. We really thank God for that. However, a number of people are in critical situation in hospitals in Israel. And the government of Israel is reacting promptly. It was one of the first nations in the world that brought forth very severe measures in order to limit the movement of the people, in order to prevent the virus to spread from one person to the next. The Prime Minister of Israel, Benjamin Netanyahu, he just declared a few days ago at a press conference that Israel is at war against an invisible enemy. And he called upon the entire population to stand with him in this war in order to make sure that lives are being saved here in the land of Israel. The measures are very severe at the moment. That means everybody is asked to stay at home. Only very essential companies are allowed to continue operation on a reduced staff. Of course, supermarkets, gas stations, doctor's offices, hospital, gas stations, they remain open, but at the same time, anything else has been closed down here in the land of Israel, including the Christian embassy, where our staff is working from home. We have to say, however, that this virus epidemic, as it is hitting Israel, also opened unique ways for us to minister to the people of Israel. Over the last few weeks, we could help in particular in the area of Haifa, lonely people that were not able to buy groceries, which they have been asked to stay home due to their age or also because they have been infected by the coronavirus. Our team was packing parcels for them in Haifa, but also here in Jerusalem, delivering them to people who are old, who are sick with the coronavirus. And this help was really received with incredible joy and thankfulness that they saw there were people here in Jerusalem, even Christians, that were thinking of them and are standing with them in this time of need. Also, our team at the Haifa Home for Holocaust Survival is working tirelessly. Our dining room has been asked to be closed down in order to avoid larger gatherings. So our team is there three times a day. They bring freshly prepared meals to the inhabitants of the Home for Holocaust Survivors in order to make sure that they have somebody to talk to, but also that they get their regular meals in their home. This work actually met the attention of the Prime Minister's office in one of the recent statements. He was referring to the work in Haifa, that in the midst of this whole crisis, there is good news here in the land, that people are reaching out in the city of Haifa to corona victims and to elderly to provide them the necessary food. So we are very thankful for God to God for this great opportunity. I do ask you to stand with us in this critical time. God really, he did open a door for us to bless this nation, to make them feel that they are not alone, but people around the world are standing with them. We do know that countless Christians around the world, they are praying at this time and at this season for the nation of Israel. So I want to encourage you to continue standing with us. Even though our physical office is shut down, the ministry of the Christian embassy continues at full speed. We are still working and we're talking on a daily basis with the Jewish agency, helping new immigrants to come back. Of course, those new immigrants, as they arrive, they will be immediately quarantined, which put an extra burden on the Jewish agency. We have been helped to assist also in this area. And there are many other projects where we are right now active, right at the pulse of this nation, to help them in this very critical moment in the history of Israel. So I do ask you to stand with us in prayer, to be with us united. We remain your embassy here in Jerusalem. We are here, your outstretched arm and your feet here in the land of Israel, to bless the Jewish people. And we have never needed your prayers and your support as today, because the opportunities of ministry are countless. So please stand with us. Please pray for our ministry. We are here in the land of Israel for you at this critical time. God bless you from Jerusalem.